You're not running out on me, are you?
Sorry, no, I was just...
No, it happens all the time. Whoa, it's like somebody's keeping the tooth fairy busy.
Yes, you can say that.
Shall we?
Oh, sure.
Listen, Mary. I know coming to the dentist can be frightening. But I want to let you know we're not monsters.
Speak for yourself.
Oh, you. Sue, this is Mary. Mary Sue.
Hi.
I just don't see why I have to have my teeth pulled. They feel perfectly fine.
Sure, sure. Your teeth feel fine now. But those wisdom teeth tend to shift around, and before you know it, you have a mouthful of trouble.
Oh. You know, dentistry's come a long way since your small parents got their teeth ripped out in the back of a barn.
My parents still go up
there. Recent advancements in modern dentistry have rendered the process practically painless. Came right off. A few tugs of this and you'll hardly remember we had this conversation.
It's like helping yourself to a nice bottle of wine.
Or 10. Okay. So, Mary. What do you say? Yeah, that's right.
Deep breaths through the nose.
That's right. How does that feel, Mary? A little woozy? There you go.
Yeah.
Sorry about that. Third molar, Sue. Okay. It's num-num time. Wide now. Wide. Good. Okay. Just a prick and a burn. There it is. You know, you have beautiful teeth. Has anyone told you that?
Mm-mm.
It's almost sumptuous. Sue, you've got to see this. Up, open. There we go. Wide. How much do you give per tooth? How much do you give per tooth? Most give a nickel, some a dime. One lady went quarter per tooth. What a kook. What about you? What do you give? What? Sorry?
I give 10 cents.
Oh. That a girl. Okay. Very still now. Did anyone ever tell you the original story of the tooth fairy?
Uh-uh.
No?
Mm-mm.
Creepy stuff. And all done. I'm gonna give that a moment to sit. Anyhow, original tooth fairies were a sight different than the winged women we often think of today. Winged. Is that a word? Originally, they were called the Bone Gru, a mighty race of creatures that lived beneath the earth and fed on the bones and teeth of the dead.
They ate bones?
And teeth. See, a child would lose a tooth and the parents would bury it in the ground. And the Gru would sense it and they would be appeased. Hmm. Sue, could you give me some gauze? Eventually, the humans evolved and moved into cities. And they no longer had ground to bury their teeth in. So they put them under their pillow. The children loved it, and the Bone Gru could still eat.
Seems like a lot of... Seems like a lot of trouble to go through for some measly teeth.
Well, it adds up. Relaxed? Whoops. Now, Mary, we're not free.
Let's get this over with. It's almost lunchtime.
Yeah. She's up.
All right, ready to go?
Here we are. Now the nurse will have instruction on your way out. Call us if you have too much pain. Oh, and let's get that child of yours in here, sooner rather than later.